don't know who took them or why, it becomes utterly unbearable for those closest to them. If you like this video, then please hit the notification bell so that every week you'll know when we post a new video for you to check out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week. Five strange and creepy unsolved mysteries. It's in our nature to find answers so we can make sense of the world around us. But unfortunately, they aren't always easy to find. The cases on this list are examples of just that, and will leave you wanting to find the truth. These are five strange and creepy unsolved mysteries. Number five, Lyle Stevick. It was Friday, September 14, 2001, when a man in a gray shirt with a blue plaid top and jeans walked into the Quonset Inn in Amanda Park, Washington. He wrote down the name Lyle Stevick and paid for a single night stay, but told the receptionist that he might stay for a few more days. He brought no luggage with him. In fact, the only thing he had in hand was a toothbrush and toothpaste. Nothing seemed that unusual with Lyle until a few days later on September 17th when he was found dead inside his hotel room. Police ruled his death a suicide. He was found inside the hotel closet having hanged himself by the neck using his belt and the clothes railing. During the investigation, police found a crumpled note with the word suicide written on it, along with $160 and $20 bills with the words scribbled on them for the room. When police traced the address he wrote down upon check-in, it led to a Best Western hotel in Meridian, Idaho. The hotel said they couldn't remember whether Lyle had been there or not. Police then realized that the name Lyle Stevick may have been an alias, having been borrowed from a character in a Joyce Oates novel titled You Must Remember This. In it, a character named Lyle Stevick was a furniture owner that contemplated committing suicide by hanging himself from the rafters. Police gathered DNA, dental records, and fingerprints, hoping to identify